So we're going to be talking about the dream interpretation, the meaning of the dreams, the importance of understanding the dreams, and then we'll have a little bit of time for questions and answers at the end. Right? So welcome, everybody. Let me start by saying a little bit, talking a little bit about why I'm so excited about dreams. Ever since I was a little girl, I had dreams that kind of stuck in my mind, and I started to realize that there was consistency. One of the things that was happening, if you've heard the term precognitive dreams, so it's dreams that you see and then something happens. And that was my first realization that something special was going on with the dreams. My dad used to travel a lot. And as Paula mentioned, I'm from Uzbekistan, which is former Soviet Union. And back when I was growing up, we did not have phones. It's a simple thing, but we didn't have them. So the form of communication was kind of non-existent in terms of if someone travels elsewhere. And my dad used to travel quite a bit on business trips. And sometimes he would come the time when he said he would, sometimes he would come a little bit later, sometimes a little bit earlier. And so what was happening with me is that I would dream the night before he would come home, I would always have a dream that he comes home. And in the morning, I usually wake up and he's at home, or that day he comes. And it was very, very on the clock specific. So I realized there was something to it. And I was little and didn't really know much about it. But I used to ask my grandma, what does this mean when I see this in dreams? What does it mean when I see that in dreams? And so she was teaching me the things that she knew. And then eventually I was reading a lot of different books and looking for a lot of different answers, until eventually I came across a very particular structured way to interpret dreams. Dreams actually are coming from our subconscious mind. And so you're probably aware of that we have the conscious mind, the subconscious mind, and the superconscious mind. And the subconscious mind is 95% of what we operate on. So we're really not quite aware usually of things that are coming from somewhere, right? But we don't really know. Beliefs, programs, information, all of that is stored there. And dreams allow us to get to tap, because when we sleep, the conscious mind is out. And we go into the subconscious mind and we actually receive information from there. And our subconscious mind has a lot of information that's really, really useful for us. And so once we understand the language of communication with the subconscious mind, it's yet another language. We can get into the subconscious mind through meditation. We can get to it through other means. But dreams is very easy and very simple way to actually connect. Everybody dreams, and we dream every night. And sometimes people say, but I didn't see any dreams. What happens is that we don't remember. The only times when we don't dream is that when we don't actually fall asleep. So sometimes we'll have some ways of, some forms of insomnia, so you don't really fully fall asleep deeply, and that's when we don't see dreams. I've had dreams when I was just falling asleep. I wasn't even completely asleep, and I would start seeing dreams. And some of you might have had that experience. So some of us are more connected to the subconscious mind, and the more we actually embrace that, the more we start understanding it, the more we start listening to it, the more information surfaces up. So people who started to interpret their dreams, and age does not matter, I've had students who started to interpret their dreams at 70. One of the ladies came over to one of the workshops, just introduction, and she said, I actually came to learn how can I stop seeing all the dreams, because I didn't like my dreams at all. Every time I would see something appearing, they were always in black and white, and it gave me some scare, and I just wanted to stop seeing them altogether. So after she left the workshop, she learned that apparently there is importance to the dreams, and then she learned how to see the dreams and to remember and interpret them, and everything has changed. She stopped seeing the dreams that bothered her, and she started to see other dreams. So we go into the subconscious mind, and imagine that our subconscious mind has layers, and the deeper we go, the different layer we get into. So the most immediate layer, the emotional layer, is where our emotions come from, etc. And so that's kind of, we go into that, and then we can go deeper. And depending on the quality of the dream and certain features of the dreams, and I will be talking about that a little bit more during the workshop, you will actually understand how deep you went into the subconscious mind for that message? Was it more on the surface? Was it really deep? And some dreams can be life-changing. So why dreams are important to remember? Sometimes people say, well, it's just a dream. I'll give you an example of something that probably most people do have experienced at least once in their lifetime, is a nightmare. And let's say you have a child, and that's actually kind of how I ended up here, a little bit of the anecdotal story. I was here at a completely different workshop as a participant, and one of the participants asked a question. Unrelated, it was about past lives, Dream Kelly, a magnificent workshop. And the woman in the audience asked about her daughter having a recurring nightmare. And she basically was trying to figure out how to stop that. And that's one of the most important dreams to interpret. One, a nightmare, and second, when it's recurring. Nightmares bring information to us that is so important that, and we usually try to not remember, try to ignore, especially child, right? The child comes to us and we say, it's just a dream. If you understand how to interpret dreams, you actually can tap into the subconscious mind of your child and understand what might be troubling them. Something that the child might not be aware of, something they might not be able to express or explain or be ashamed of, etc. So recurring dreams, and again, I'll cover that a little bit more during the workshop, are messages from the subconscious mind where the soul is basically saying, or our subconscious mind is saying, you have to pay attention to me. And every single time when we actually do pay attention, when we interpret that dream, 99.9% of the times, it stops. Once you interpret it, it stops. The nightmare, again, it's the scream. You have to pay attention to me. So once you understand that, it goes away. So, and some people have that. Some people have the same exact dream, night over night. There are very interesting historical examples also of importance of the dreams. And maybe some of them you've heard about and some of them not. So through dreams, people got inspired for creation of art, music, poetry. Through dreams, people have received information that was important, scientific discoveries. Through dreams, people got changes in the world history. For example, Napoleon used to dream about the battle, how to conquer something, you know, a place in the battle in the dream, and he would then implement it, and he was pretty successful. Shakespeare used to dream a lot of information that he then incorporated into his books, into his plays. One of the interesting facts that not a lot of people know is how dreams can change history. Adolf Hitler, when during the First World War, was a soldier and he was in a bunker and he fell asleep. And while he was sleeping, he saw a dream. And in that dream, he saw the earth shattering and the debris and the earth basically falling on him. And he felt suffocated. He felt very uncomfortable. And so he woke up and was very, very vivid. He woke up and he just ran outside from the bunker and he wanted to get some fresh air. And while he was outside, right, that second, a shell hit the bunker and everybody who was in it died. So if he did not see that dream, the history of the world would be very different. So I know that, and again, that's a pretty famous example. Many people might know that Dmitry Mendeleev was a Russian chemist who put together the periodic table that everybody in the world is using now. He had all the information about all the elements, but he intuitively felt that there was some kind of connection, but he couldn't figure it out. And so he was thinking about it, and basically what he was doing, he was giving the task to his subconscious mind. He wanted to figure it out. So he fell asleep while he was trying to figure it out, and in his dream, he saw the exact pattern, and he woke up, and that's the exact pattern that we see now in the periodic table. So, and that, if you remember periodic table, that's pretty complex, right? So he saw everything. I think that that he changed like one little thing from, as far as I remember, that's it. Everything else was entirely dreamt. Niels Bohr, physicist Niels Bohr, also dreamt he first realized the model of atom while he was dreaming about it. So there are some people who used dreams throughout the history, and there are many, many, many examples where they wanted to find inspiration, where they wanted to find answer to questions and many other things. And what we're going to be doing during the workshop, we're actually going to tap into how can you resolve certain things, find the answers that are already there. Again, the 95%. So imagine everybody's really smart, knowledgeable, all the years of experience, everything that you can think of. That's only 5% of everything you know. Isn't that amazing? And 95% we're carrying around, and we usually don't even know how to tap into it. So it's quite amazing. I've had my own interesting experiences in what dreams did for me. And again, every time I saw that or experienced that, I got even more interested and more fascinated. I'll give you a few of my own examples and experiences. So at some point, one of my grandmas was really ill, and she was in coma, and she was in coma for about 2 weeks at that point. And, she could have come out anytime or might have never come out. I never knew. So one night I was having a dream, and it was kind of indirect interpretation. Again, I'll talk about it more during the actual class. I saw that I caught a dead fish, and I woke up with knowledge that my grandma passed away. And I looked at the clock, and I remember it was 4:06 a.m. And I went to the hospital the next morning to see her, as I did every morning. And they told me that she passed, and the time of her death was exactly 4:06 a.m. So, to me, things like that were always kind of confirming the importance, because in my life, a lot of things that happened that were either related to other people or to my own experience, that they were really, really important. One of the interesting examples, also a dream that I had. I moved here, and my now husband was still in Uzbekistan. We actually were not planning to get married or anything like that. And we used to date, and then we separated, and so it's kind of a long story. But right before I moved, we kind of talked and, thought it would be maybe a great idea to get together, but I was moving away for the rest of my life, and there was no chance for him to come over here at all. So 3 years went by, and I was here, and he was back in Uzbekistan. And I was kind of getting very lost in terms of what's going to happen with that relationship. Is there a chance of it to happen? Is it not? Should I move on? What's going on? And so one night I just lay down and I just prayed to God. And I'm not a religious person. I do believe in God. I'm spiritual. I have a spiritual background. So I prayed to God to just give me some answer. What should I do? And that night I saw a dream. And in that dream, I was laying on top of the mountain of some kind or a hill. It was beautiful fall day, bright sunshine. And I'm just looking up in the sky. And all of a sudden, I see him coming over. And I was surprised, stunned. What are you doing here? He says, well, I was on the bus. And then suddenly, the bus broke. The tire blew up. And the driver told us to actually get out and just go for a walk. And so I was walking, and I saw you. And that was it. And I woke up, and I was thinking, oh, my God, somehow the universe is going to bring us together. And I remember telling this dream to a friend of mine who was actually quite skeptical. 2 weeks later, he calls me and he says he won a green card in a lottery. And if you don't know, there is actually such thing. You can win green card to live in this country in a lottery. Here's the fun part. He didn't even apply. His sister did it for him. So what are the chances of that? And so when I told my friend, who was very skeptical, she said, if you did not tell me the dream when you actually saw it and you told me it as a story, I would never believe that it was true. But things like that happen. So again, you can get a lot of information. Can be the signs, precognitive things. Can be quite useful too. One of the fun examples, we were selling our apartment and trying to buy a house. And that was, I can't remember the year, but that was right before before the market crashed. And so we had a contract basically for both. And last minute, people who were buying our apartment suddenly decided not to do that. So other, you know, would be complications, etc. So we're just thinking, okay, well, market is good, so we're just going to put it up again and someone else is going to buy it. And I saw a dream, and in my dream, another grandma, I was very close with her, came over. So it's called the visitation dream. And she was basically telling me it's not the time. How she was telling me was a little bit symbolic. So I was growing watermelons, and they were really small. She said, you know, it's not time for them yet. So you have to let them grow and ripe, you know, not time yet to pick them up. And so I woke up understanding that it's not time yet for me to be selling this apartment. I did not understand why. And so my husband was really anxious because he really wanted that house. Something was delaying constantly with the apartment. And so basically we had to get out of the contract for the house because, you know, the sale was not happening. And somehow everything worked out. So we got out and everything was fine. And literally, and we were still thinking we might still have time to sell and to buy and whatnot. That's when the market crashed and everything went down. And if we have bought that house, we would have wasted about maybe $200,000. And all the repairs and everything else, so the value went significantly down. So in the dream, my grandma basically gave me an advice not to hurry up and do that because it's not really the right time. So dreams can save you money too. All right. So dreams develop intuition. What I've noticed is that when people follow at least this approach, but it can be different because sometimes people learn somehow to understand their dreams without necessarily a particular approach. But that's what I will be teaching in the class, in the workshop. What starts happening is that the more we embrace that, and it's our intuition, it's part of our intuition, the more intuitive abilities are going to develop, and the more people are actually getting, not just from the dreams, but in waking life. So they start having more of the different experiences. Because again, a lot of that is coming from the subconscious. And the more we're connected to it, the more amazing experiences we might be having. The more we listen to it, the more it talks to us. So you can solve problems, you can actually receive healing, you can communicate. You can talk to someone who has passed, and those are called visitation dreams, and you can initiate that as well. You can solve many different problems, and it can be very trivial. So sometimes it can be, I have a choice, and I can figure out which one is the best for me because it seems like they're kind of, you know, either both not perfect or both really good. And you literally can ask those questions before you go to bed, and you might be receiving the answers if you know how to listen. And I will teach you at the end of tonight, I will teach you how to remember your dreams, and it's the technique that works 100% for everybody. Usually takes maximum 2 weeks, even for people who don't remember their dreams. I've had people who come and say, I remember nothing. And those people come back 2 weeks later and say, yep, I remember the dream. So it does work, and I'll teach you. But so we receive a lot of information. We can resolve things. I mean, I've used that for, as Paula mentioned, I come from IT background. I've spent 14 years in IT world. I was a business analysis manager. And at times I would have these IT problems, a project, very trivial. And I would try to figure out how to resolve something. And that's how I would fall asleep thinking about it. And I would wake up sometimes in the middle of the night with the solution, or in the morning I would know exactly what to do. So again, tapping into the subconscious. We'll talk more about all the different types of dreams and what they do during the class, but just to mention, lucid dreams is something else. And lucid dreams are the dreams where you wake up and become consciously aware that you are actually dreaming. And there is a difference between, sometimes people say, kind of, I knew I was dreaming in the dream, but the consciousness is not 100% fully present. So you're kind of on your way there, but it's not lucid yet. Lucid is when you actually consciously become aware that you are dreaming and you become in full control of your dream. Anybody had a dream like that? Oh, wonderful. All right. So you know how much fun that is, right? So I don't know what you've used your opportunity on. I always start with flying. I want to fly. So I end up flying, and then at some point I realized I had really amazing, really long dream, lucid dream. And so I flew around, and then I decided that I want to go through the ceiling, and I did that. And then I decided I actually want to find out. I ended up in a space that was kind of between the worlds in the dream. And that I'm going to find out what happens to people when they die. And there were people there. I was like, I'm going to ask questions. It was the only time when that happened, because I usually spend the entire lucid dream on flying, so just having fun. And I actually did, and I started asking questions. What happens when you die? And if this is going to happen or that is going to happen? And I received the answer, so it was pretty amazing. And you can do whatever you like. You can ask anything about yourself or your life. And I know that sometimes it's triggered by having something that's maybe unpleasant. Many times lucid dreams are triggered by people, and actually in my case that particular one was having some kind of a nightmare. It was an unpleasant thing happening. And then, you know, I was asking questions, and then I realized that I was dreaming, and then I removed everything that was unpleasant about the dream and ended up doing whatever I liked. So that's fun. And again, during the workshop, I'll teach you, it's very simple method. A lot of amazing things are very, very simple, but you just have to do it, practice it. And again, it's pretty quickly how you start seeing, when you start seeing the lucid dreams. So, and then you can repeat as often as you like. So the method that I'm using is based on a few different approaches. One of them I have learned studying at the School of Metaphysics. Big part of it. And then I've also been studying Edgar Cayce's work. I don't know if you, probably a lot of you are familiar. We have ARE organization, actually all over the place, but including in Illinois. And the combination of that, and he has written a lot of books and a lot of information that he shared. There is actually even an application, and I'll share with you that. During the workshop. So I've added that and some of my personal experiences, because some of the things that I know are happening to myself and a lot of other people were missed out. And so I've consistently applied it, and I've been teaching people how to interpret their dreams for some time now too. And they end up having a lot of aha moments. So what's important with that is practice, because part of it is very structured, and that's what we will learn. And part of it is art. So it's almost like when you speak a language, the first you start by putting together, learning words, right? And you start putting together words, and then you kind of speak a sentence, and then eventually you can write poetry. So interpreting dreams is kind of like that. It's a process. So it takes some time, but then eventually you can understand so much more. So at this point, for example, if someone comes to me and I do the mind transformation coaching, if the person says nothing about themselves, and I just learn, I can include like astrologically, what is their date of birth? What is their full name? I can use numerology. What are their chronic diseases and physical disorders? And dreams consistently recurring or for the past months, I can tell probably 90% of what's going on with the person. Some of it they might not be even aware of, because all of that stuff is coming from the subconscious and predisposition and other things. Dreams are absolutely amazing. If you can read someone's dreams for the last month, 2 months, 3 months, a year, especially actually going back to a year, two, three, you can tell what was happening with this person's life just going through their dreams, because everything that's happening to our waking life is reflected through the dreams. All right, so ready to learn how to remember dreams? All right. And you, if you want to write it down, you can. It's very simple. So first of all, you want to be disciplined with that, and you want to have a notebook by your bed, and you want to have a pen by your bed. And before you go to bed tonight, actually, especially if you're coming to the workshop, and I will be saying that the same, I'll be teaching this on Saturday as well, but the second part of the workshop is going to be practical. We'll actually be interpreting your dreams. And what's important is that you interpret the dreams that just happened. A lot of people come and say, okay, when I was 12, I saw this dream. And that's curiosity. I'll tell you what it means. But there is nothing you can do about that dream anymore, because it was a really long time ago. Well, maybe not so long for some of you. But when it's something that you saw last night, you want to act on that. That's important. That's happening right now. Some people have recurring dream and they keep seeing the same dream over and over since they were little or for the last 10 years or etc. That we can definitely pay attention to, and we will, and we'll interpret that. But what you would want to do is from now until especially the second part of the workshop, you want to be writing down every single dream that you see documented. So you write down right before you go to bed. So you've done everything else. Your mind is free of everything else, right? So everything you're going to be doing tomorrow, you thought about your day, you did whatever routine that you do. Write down the date of tomorrow. So tonight is 16th, you're going to write down June 17th. And you write down, I will remember my dream or dreams. Okay, it's very simple. I will remember my dreams. And it's the last thing you think about when you go to bed. And when you wake up, and if you wake up in the middle of the night or you wake up in the morning, the very first thing before you start thinking about your day and what you have to do and the jobs that you have to go to and whatever else, or your kids, the very first thing you think about is, what did you see last night? And you write it down. Now, you might have remembered that you just saw an elephant. That's all you remember. Start writing it down. You might say, well, I just remember it was something somewhere, but I don't remember what. Write it down. Whatever it is, it might be a feeling. It might be a word. It might be one image. It might be just a little piece. What you will learn when you do it consistently is that you're going to remember more and more. And at times, it starts with, I saw an elephant, and before you know, you've written three pages. Because when you tap into it, but you have to do it right when you wake up, the first thing, because you're still in that state in between. You wake up, you're still in your subconscious mind. And you can still just catch that dream and write it down, bring it from the subconscious. Let's say you remember nothing. Write down, I remember nothing. And then throughout the day, you go about your day and something happens and it triggers. You've had that? Oh my God, I remember the dream from last night. That's when you want to write it down. And here is why it's important to write dreams down instead of thinking that you're going to remember them. When you write them down exactly as you remember at that moment, whatever was happening. There are some nuances that are important for the dream interpretation. Again, that we'll be learning through the workshop. So for example, you think you saw a friend, but you are not sure. Someone who kind of seemed like a friend, but it wasn't really 100% a friend. Or it was someone who may be looking like a friend. And then you go throughout the day, and your conscious mind starts analyzing and adding stuff and embellishing and removing. And some stuff you will forget, and some stuff you will change, you will embellish. So by the end of the day, you will remember that you saw your friend in a dream, but that's not what you saw. And those nuances actually make a difference when you interpret the dreams. So you want to write exactly what you saw, exactly how you saw it, any emotions, anything else. Okay? So then tomorrow night, you write down again the last thing that you do before you go to bed, the date of the following day, and you write down, I will remember my dreams. You go to bed, and in the morning you do the same. Doing this consistently every single night and morning for 2 weeks always produces results, even when people do not remember their dreams. And you can teach your kids or grandkids to do the same thing, and you will tap into their subconscious mind. Once you learn how to interpret what they're seeing, you will be able to actually understand what's happening with them. Okay? And then if you will have any questions afterwards, feel free to ask me. So a little bit more of what we're going to be covering on Saturday is going to be related to specifically focusing on how to interpret the dreams. We'll focus on certain aspects. We'll cover, I will tell you where to go. And so what's important about it is that you don't, and that's what I like about this approach, you don't become dependent on always going to a book to understand something. And this is what did not work for me when I, because I believe me, I looked through a lot of different books on dream interpretation, the dream dictionaries. You might get, and let's say some of them are accurate. So you got a bunch of different symbols that you looked in the book, but to understand how to put them together, that's important. And there is something that's very important in the process that most of us miss out on. And again, that's what we're going to be covering during the class. So it's almost like if you have a bunch of different words, but it doesn't really create a sentence, right? It's not really communicating to someone else. It doesn't provide that information, doesn't deliver the message. So you want those words to form a message, and you want to understand what all the symbols that you're dreaming about, what kind of message your subconscious mind is delivering to you. Okay? So before I conclude, I'll tell you probably the most fascinating dream story that I've had experienced. And I didn't even think that was possible to have. But I have, when I was 15 years old, up until that time, so 7 to 15, I went to school with someone. And I have about, when was that? About 15 years later, for a period of time, about 10 years, I started to see, and I don't know what happened to that person. So we just parted when we were both 15. I had no idea what was happening with that person. I started to see a dream about him, knowing nothing about him, was not thinking about him. And what was interesting is that in the dream, I was in the same place where I grew up, same house, the same city, the same everything. He was in the same house, the same city, same everything. Except life was unfolding very differently than the actual life that was unfolding for me. And another fascinating fact was that it was not the same dream. It was recurring. But imagine you are watching a movie and you watch one episode, and then you watch, or maybe like a soap opera, right? And you watch another episode, and then another episode. They're all connected. They were always in logical order. Something was happening, nothing major. And that's why I was always interested in why. But I would see life unfolding, and I would see a dream, you know, today, and then 2 weeks from now, and then 6 months from now. But it was always in order. And I was seeing it for about 10 years. And I was always curious, why on earth am I seeing these dreams? And I couldn't understand, nor did I have any answers. And the typical interpretation of those dreams did not really make sense. So eventually I moved here and I didn't know where he was. So eventually I found him, and he happened to move to another country, and then he ended up moving to another country, to Canada actually. And so we were connected, just chatting with each other. And at some point, and I was thinking about it for a while, how is it going to sound if I haven't seen someone for, 25 years, 30 years? Asked someone, do you sometimes see dreams about me maybe? And it's going to sound a little bit strange, right? So finally I thought, okay, you know, I'm just going to do it. And I asked, you know, I'm going to ask you a really strange question. And it's more like a scientist in me. do you ever happen to see any dreams about me, etc.? And so here's what unfolds is that apparently, ever since he was 15, 16 years old, so he moved out, he's been seeing recurring dreams of his life unfolding. It was very different from my dreams and was very similar. He would see sometimes once a week, once in 6 months, you know, once a month. And it was also in a particular sequence. And he was seeing dreams about me. And so we were seeing in parallel dreams, never connected, never talking to each other. Nothing in common, really. And once we had that conversation, all those dreams stopped. Once I cleared it out and we had conversation about why we were having those dreams, all those dreams stopped. And if I never asked that question or I never found him, I might have been seeing them until now. So there are a lot of interesting things that are happening, a lot of different stories that I hear from people and what dreams do for them. So it's really absolutely fascinating topic, and I don't think that you can ever get enough of that.
Yeah, you said if you do that practice for 2 weeks, and let me see if I get it right. So you write down, I'm going to remember my dreams mm-hmm. before you go to sleep. Mm-hmm. And then you can kind of pre-program what you want to dream about. Like I want to write mm-hmm. a book, or I want to achieve this results, et cetera. And then you let your subconscious do the planning for you. And then you wake up in the morning, and then you write down what you can remember from that dream. And then during the day, you kind of figure out what that dream meant and fill in a few more missing pieces to it in this journal. And then you repeat that process for 2 weeks, and then you get results. What kind of results do you get?
So there are a couple of pieces there that overlapping. The process of you writing down, I will remember my dreams, and doing it every night, and then waking up, and the first thing in the morning you do, you write down what the dream was, whatever you remember. That's a separate process. That's the process for you to remember your dreams. So for the part that I covered for right now, for the next 2 weeks, just write down, I will remember my dreams every night. And when you wake up, write down whatever you remember and do it every single night and every single morning. And make sure that, again, if you wake up in the middle of the night, you do that. Or in the middle of the day, if you remember the dream, that's when you want to write it down. But have your notebook by your bedside so that you actually have that and you don't think I'm going to write it down later, because you will forget. Most people forget. So that's a separate part. And then what's going to happen in 2 weeks is that even if you do not remember your dreams consistently, or some people say, I dream once in a blue moon, that's not true. People don't remember their dreams. Within 2 weeks, most people start remembering at least some of the dreams, at least one dream. And that's already something. And the more consistently you will do it for a longer period of time, the more consistently you will be remembering the dreams. I've had people who start to remember 25 dreams a night. By the way, there is something that for a Saturday, I'll bring it over. Another thing, it's a really cool tool to use if you want to help yourselves to remember the dreams. If you ever heard of a Herkimer diamond, it's a crystal. I'm into crystals. Love crystals. Herkimer diamond is a special type of crystal that's formed not the way that regular crystal is formed, and it has very different properties. They're usually small, and I'll bring them over. So if you will decide to try that, if you already have it, and that worked, everybody who tried it, it worked with everybody. It usually works the first night, can be the second night. Just tape it to your forehead when you go to bed. Hopefully you don't sleep on your forehead, because that's going to leave a dent. But tape it to your forehead, and you can do the same thing too, that I will remember my dreams. But I did it only once, because the entire night, all I was doing, watching a movie of my dreams. The whole 8 hours, nonstop, I remembered every single dream. It gets exhausting. So I took it off at some point. But first night or second night, I think it usually takes one or two nights. So especially if you have hard time remembering the dreams, that can help you as well.
Thank you. This might be slightly related to this question, but mm-hmm. Is the subconscious connected to a higher self then? I mean, is there a correlation between those two? Because I always thought the subconscious was more of a mind thing that was, you know, keeping things protected. Mm-hmm. But you're making a connection between that and something a lot higher.
Mm-hmm. So I would not say that I am the greatest expert on understanding that. I've studied that quite a bit. I have my something that makes sense to me. But because it's not something we can dissect and say, well, here is the subconscious, superconscious, and the conscious, it's more of the conceptual thing. The conscious mind is the mind that we use in waking life. So you're here, hopefully not sleeping and dreaming yet. So that's the conscious mind that you're thinking with. The subconscious mind, and the point of that is to discern, to reason. Right? So that's the purpose of the conscious mind. If we're using it productively, unproductively used, it's a wild monkey. The subconscious mind is a reservoir of information and knowledge that is gathered throughout the lifetimes, etc. Now, here's the thing. If I ask you right now to describe to me in detail what's happening behind your back, consciously, most likely, you would have no clue. But if I put you into a hypnotic state, you would tell me in detail the pattern on on the wall behind you or something else, and in every single detail. And people turn around, it's like seeing what's behind my back, right? So on the subconscious level, we pick up all the information that the conscious mind, because otherwise we'll go nuts. The conscious mind in our brain works this way. It actually kind of takes away all the extra information and not focusing on it. That's kind of a challenge for people who, labeled to have ADD, is that it's hard for them to filter. Information comes at a huge speed, and it's hard for them to filter. They don't have that natural ability as developed as someone without it. And so they get overwhelmed. Now, if we always saw and paid attention to everything happening around us, we would get overwhelmed. But all of that goes into the subconscious mind. And all of it is stored in the subconscious mind indefinitely. Conscious mind is the aspect of the human life experience, the physical life experience. But if you ever read anybody who had near-death experience, they all describe some kind of mind, some kind of consciousness, being there, understanding something, reasoning, etc. And so, and it's probably not the same mind. And then they tap into a lot of different things. So the subconscious mind travels with us from incarnation to incarnation. Again, if you're open to that, if you're not, that's okay. Superconscious mind is something, it's a higher self. So there is structure that I learned where it goes like this. So the source is where everything comes from. And then the source is split into individual I ams. And again, that's not where, nowhere physical level, right? Individual I ams then go into the I am, go into the next level of the superconscious mind. So it's a very high level of consciousness that some people can attain. A lot of people who are seeking enlightenment, that's what they're trying to attain. And that's, again, the direct correlation or direct connection to the source. And sometimes people have those experiences for a short period of time, and sometimes if you focus on that, you can actually have that enlightenment. Then goes the subconscious mind. And again, it's not physically structured like that, but it goes like this, but a kind of more of the conceptual. And then the conscious mind, and underneath this is our ego. And the ego is manifestation of I am in the physical form. So there are levels, there are 7 levels. Conscious mind has 1. And then the rest of them, there are 7 levels of the mind, from conscious to subconscious to superconscious. And depending on what you want to accomplish, where you are going, what kind of information you're receiving, you might be getting to different levels of subconscious and superconscious mind. So it's the topic is enormous, actually. And to say that, you know, we can just quickly cover that. If you're interested in that, maybe, you know, afterwards I can recommend you to look into something specific. But information that we receive from superconscious mind is kind of like higher self. So you can think about it this way, or at least that's my understanding. The higher self talking to us that has our best interests in mind understands something that the conscious mind or the ego does not. And subconscious mind carries a lot of information that's useful to us through which the soul communicates to us if we listen to it. And the conscious mind is the one that interprets and then applies it to the physical life.
Hi, thank you for speaking tonight. I've kept a dream journal for a couple years. I found it very helpful on many levels. So you said to write, is it correct to write out all the nuances, all the details? Really?
I know. So if you remember, so since you've been doing it in a disciplined way for 2 years, I imagine that you can remember a lot of details, right?
I can, yeah.
Yeah, fascinating. So, and again, that you're just proving the point because that's what I've seen consistently. People sometimes start with, I saw a table. Actually, I had a student. It was really funny. So I had two students in the class, and one of them was saying, he was originally from India, well, I just walked outside and was this beautiful sky and these constellations, and, you know, and there was Shiva. He was speaking to me, and he told me this and this and that. And it's absolutely fascinating dream. And she would be sitting next to him. She was just, like, cracking up and just said, and I saw a table. But once she started to tap into it more and more, what happened to you was happening to her. She started to see the nuances and details. She, for example, never saw color in her dreams up until she started to interpret, and then she started to see color. And then, we'll talk about what does it mean when you see a dream in color. I always assumed, before I started to study that more seriously, everybody saw dreams in full color, technicolor. Not true. I actually happened to ask my husband at some point. He said he always dreams in black and white. And I always dream in technicolor. And the colors that I see in my dreams can be so vivid that I've never seen them in real life like that. And it actually means something. What colors you might see. You might see dreams in light, not even colors. You might see them in pastel colors. You might see them in light. And actually, that would be getting back to where they're coming from, to from what level of mind they're coming from. They're going to have very different different coloring too. So when you know all of those details, sometimes those details will give you a very detailed answer. So the whole point of understanding the dreams is to understand what kind of guidance your subconscious mind is giving you so you're more productive in your conscious life. And very often people are just curious about what did an apple mean in my dream? And then they do absolutely nothing once they learn what apple meant, because just an apple, just a symbol, which actually can mean different things, is not giving you the information. But if you know all those details and nuances, sometimes you can actually, that means that your communication is well established. Good job. So 2 years been doing that. So you're ready to learn how to now interpret every single thing, and you can go back and you can start looking through your 2 year experience and what was happening with your life, and see how that was reflected through your subconscious mind.
Oh, yeah, I've definitely seen reoccurring symbolism, and I know exactly, okay, that means that, mm-hmm. that means that. Mm-hmm. It's been really useful.
Yeah, so,
very good, yeah. Very good.
Well, thank
Wonderful.
You.
My pleasure. You know, a little bit of the anecdotes while you're thinking, if you have any other questions. My little sister, she's 9 years younger than me, was not really interested in anything that I was doing, metaphysics, etc. And how I got to her was that one fine day, she was telling me about a dream that she saw. And I started to interpret it for her. And I could see her reaction that she was stunned. Like, how would I know that? Like, something she's thinking about, she's not telling me. She was not very sharing, like, well, this is what I'm feeling, this is what I'm thinking. You would have to guess. And she was like, how do you know that? So there's something to it, right? And so she started to actually pay attention to the dreams. She would tell me the dreams, and I would interpret them for her. And eventually, she's got to the point now, so it's been going on for maybe like 4 years, she can dream answers for me better than I can dream them for myself. So she's my go-to person just in case, a backup plan. If I need to find out some answer to something, like something intricate, can you please ask that in your dream? She can actually dream the answers for me, and she can dream them for herself. Yep. I have one talented sister.
Yeah, so when you describe the unconscious mind, what I'm getting is that it's sort of a collection of everything that's happened to you in your life that you may have forgotten about, and you can access it to help you out in your mm-hmm. conscious mind. Mm-hmm. But what you describe when your grandmother died is not something that is part of your experiences. It's more like telepathy or some psychic type of thing. So, I mean, how is that involved in the subconscious mind?
So structurally, it might not. That is an example of something that's not necessarily tapping into the reservoir of the memory, but the connection. So we experience life as something that's linear in terms of time, as this is happening now, and this happened yesterday, and this will happen tomorrow. That's our experience. The reality is that everything is happening really at the same time. And again, that's more of the maybe a theory for some people, so it depends how comfortable you feel with that. But if you just imagine that you actually have access to everything that ever happened in this lifetime with you, so something that's going to happen tomorrow, you can foresee. And that's really how clairvoyance works. When we see something didn't happen, so everything that will ever happen, and that's the Akashic records are related to that in the sense that that's where it's stored. But again, technically, you can look at it in any way. So your subconscious mind is not following your experiencing the physical life in linear manner. So you feel that was yesterday and now it's today and tomorrow is going, something else is going to happen. Subconscious mind doesn't have to follow that. The conscious mind thinks that. And so imagine that in front of you there are, well, for just simplicity, 100 different variations of what might happen tomorrow. And your mind works in a certain way and it attracts a particular variation. So this variation is most likely to happen. Your mind can perceive, and I'm not talking about conscious mind, your mind can, subconscious mind, perceive that this is what might happen. We call it intuition. And you can call it clairvoyance, clairaudience. There are different channels of intuition. So now, how does that happen? Again, you just are tapping into the subconscious mind, connected to it regardless of time. Time is a complete illusion. It helps us to, again, to some degree, to stay sane and to go through our experiences to learn something. We're tapping into something very, very different from the dreams, but just in the short, you can foresee through intuition, you can foresee through the dreams just the same way. And we will talk a little bit about it, but if you want to talk about it more afterwards, definitely let me know. Okay? I don't know if I clarified it or confused me more, because it's really a concept that's not easy to comprehend when you tell people time is an illusion and everything has happened already and you're just catching up experiencing that, but your soul and someone already knows how it's going to end, so the conscious mind just catching up to experience that.
Thank you. Hello everybody. I came late, I'm sorry about that, but I catch something. What happened with those dreams that happens 10 or 15 years ago or 20 years ago, but you still having the fresh memory about that? Or, for example, I had a couple dreams where I see myself through the eyes, and I hear in different language also, they say, you can remember certain dreams and see your body, for example, mm-hmm. but never you see yourself through the eyes. Mm-hmm. And that catch me, and sometimes I can dream.
Yeah.
I mean, it's something that I have, and I have to have the meaning of that, because it's it happens 20 years ago, and 20 years ago I was a teenager. I don't have any notion of the interpretation of the dreams. Mm-hmm. Other thing, for example, a couple dreams, like you say, are recurrent, mm-hmm. but after 6 years or a long time, and like you say, probably writing what happened in my dream, I will recognize the message. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I stop dreaming because I say, okay, sometimes I want to happen something, and I will dream about that, and mm-hmm. I will make it happen. Mm-hmm. But what is the connection to desire something and just think, oh, it will happen, and now is my real life, conscious life? Who says I never sleep? I have that dream 1 week ago, and now it's happening like that.
Right, so it's called precognitive dream. When you actually, and there are two ways of doing that. So one is that you can foresee what's about to happen. So kind of related to your question, that you would foresee something and it happens. And that's called precognitive dream. So, and that's sometimes really cool and can be very simple things. Another is when you program yourself for something. So that's manifestation. That's something that you want to create, and you create it in your dream, in your subconscious mind, and you manifest it. So a little bit of the difference. In terms of seeing the first part of the question, if I understood you correctly, you saw something that was, the dream was about you, but you were not seeing it from inside your body, but kind of outside of your body. Is that correct?
I was facing myself. Like, I'm seeing you, I know it was you. Uh-huh.
So it was the two of you. You were facing yourself, and then you knew that was me, and then I'm facing myself. So it was kind of, okay. So right there is already a meaning. There is actually already interpretation. There was some kind of a self-reflection. And an interesting thing is that it does not matter how old you are. We have this ability since we're born. Whether you can interpret your dreams or not, you will still see them. So you might as well learn how to interpret them. So it's kind of like it's a gift. And once you learn how to interpret it more and more, you will tap into something that right now is just dormant. It's there, and people say, oh, it's just a dream. But it's not. It's a huge helper in how you can be productive, successful, happier in your life, how you can overcome a lot of obstacles, how you can be more creative, how you can heal yourself, how can you can do a lot of different things. Another thing too, so you missed that part when I said, to interpret what happened to you 20 years ago is not as important because it happened 20, like the dream, 20 years ago, right? So what you want to interpret is what you saw last night, because that's relevant to your life right now. But what happens sometimes is that people ask me, okay, well, what does this mean, dream means? Because I saw it for 20 years when I was, you know, little, every night, or when I was growing up. And I don't understand what it means. I don't see it anymore, but I want to understand. And I would tell them the meaning of the dream, and they would have an aha moment. Oh my God, it completely makes sense. So it's just peace of mind to know, but there is nothing you can really do about it because you don't dream it anymore. That has passed, and so you don't really have to worry about that as much as you want to focus on what you dreamt about last night to understand that and live your life according to that, because that's information that's the most relevant. But out of curiosity, absolutely. Once you learn how to interpret a dream, you can interpret anything from 20, 50, 70 years ago.